Hey everybody, Steve Eveleth here, Livermore, California, Real Estate Success. How's everyone doing? So today's video newsletter is going to be, should a seller do inspections before putting their home on the market? Are they required to do inspections before putting the home on the market? And just overall, is it a good idea for them to do so? The pros and cons, what traditionally happens, and then also who pays for the inspections. Let's go over some of these topics here. So traditionally how it works is a buyer makes an offer, or a seller puts their home on the market for sale. A buyer comes in and makes an offer, and traditionally and typically within that offer are what's called contingencies. Most people know what those are. There's typically three contingencies and possibly four. There's a loan contingency, an appraisal contingency, and the inspection contingency, which we're going to talk about. And occasionally, not really necessarily this hot market, but sometimes there's a fourth contingency, which could be a contingency for the seller to find a replacement property, which you don't find that too often in this market in California. But let's talk about the main subject here regarding inspections. So typically how it goes, the buyer makes an offer and there's a inspection contingency within the contract, meaning that the buyer has a certain amount of time to fully investigate the property to their full satisfaction with whatever contingency period is stipulated in the contract. Could be 3 days, could be 5 days, could be 10 days, could be 15 days. I believe default in the contract is 17 days, but that's usually way too long, especially in a hot market. If a seller gets an offer with a 17-day inspection contingency, that can be not necessarily a big red flag, but it's a lot of risk. It's a long time for a seller to wait, because everybody knows that with as long as contingencies are in place, the buyer can back out any time for any reason with an inspection contingency in place. So if a seller gets an offer with a 17-day inspection contingency, that buyer can back out any time. That seller basically doesn't have a deal for 17 days. So in this hot market right now, typically what you're seeing is inspection contingencies anywhere from 5 to 10 days, if you're even seeing them. So let's talk about that last point there, if you're even seeing them. In this hot market right now, it's competitive, multiple offer environment. A lot of sellers are hoping for non-contingent offers, and they're getting them. But in order for a seller to get a non-contingent offer, it's a little unrealistic to expect a buyer to come in with no inspection contingency, not knowing anything about the property, and expecting the buyer to put an offer that they can't get out of and they don't know anything about the property. So this is why I'm circling back in the topic of this video, is how important it is if a seller wants a really good offer to get the pre-inspections done on the property. This way, a buyer might more realistically feel comfortable coming in with a non-contingent offer, as far as the inspections go anyway, because they're in the know. They know everything about that property based on what the third-party inspector has revealed and what the seller's disclosed and all the disclosures. So the buyer's not as in such a precarious position with systems, features, components, something wrong with the house. So they might more than likely feel more comfortable coming in with no inspection contingency. And what does this do? This also alleviates the seller from being nickeled and dimed in another round of negotiations within escrow. Like I said, typically what happens is if the seller doesn't do the inspections, that's kind of traditionally a buyer usually pays for and does their own inspections after they get their offer accepted within their contingency period of time. So the buyer writes the offer, the seller accepts the offer, the buyer then pays for and gets their own inspections done. And then based on the results of those inspections, either accepts the property, they're okay with the inspections, or circles back to the seller, wants the seller to do a bunch of repairs, or the buyer might ask the seller, darn spam calls, the buyer might ask the seller to give them a credit, or the buyer might ask to renegotiate the purchase price. So these are all things that a seller does not want to deal with in the middle of escrow, right? So typically a seller might say, well, you know, doesn't the buyer do their own inspections? The buyer pays for inspections? Well, yes, but also, do you want to deal with another round of nonsense and BS in the middle of escrow after the buyer writes their offer, they do their inspections? 99% of the time, even if a seller says as is, which is a loose term in California, the buyer still does their inspections and they always come back and ask for something. So it's better to have a buyer, especially in this hot market when buyers know that they're competing in most cases and often cases with multiple offers, it's better to have those inspections done up front for a buyer to look at. And more than likely what's going to happen is a buyer is going to put their offer in, they're going to really want the house, and in most cases they're going to know they're going to be competing with other offers, and they are more than likely not going to do more inspections. They know everything they need about the property, and they're going to go ahead and release that inspection contingency because the seller's done the inspections up front. Now, in very rare cases, just because a seller has done inspections up front, that doesn't mean the buyer can't still do their own inspections. Occasionally buyers will question, well, how do we know, you know, that the inspections are accurate? And well, it's not really an issue because you got licensed third-party inspectors and you look at the date of when the inspections were done, and as long as it's, you know, a couple of weeks or maybe even a month or two before the home was listed on the market, more than likely you're going to know that those inspections are valid, legit, and close to the time that the home is up for sale, so there's no issues. But a buyer can still, you know, come in there, and also too, just because a buyer comes in with no inspection contingency, that does not take away the buyer's right to still further investigate that property to their full satisfaction and get more inspections. But if the buyer doesn't have the inspection contingency in there, the buyer just can't back out based on further results of the buyer further investigating that property on discovery and finding things. Now, the buyer can still ask for things. This is where it gets a little slippery, right? A buyer can come in on a property with no inspection contingency, and the seller can do the inspections, and the buyer can say, you know what, we still want to do inspections, and the seller has to let the buyer still do the more inspections, and the buyer can discover more things that the previous inspections didn't, and then the buyer can still come back and ask for things. But 9 times out of 10, a seller now has ground to stand on and say no. And since the buyer doesn't have an inspection contingency in there, they're basically, they can't back out. So it's a really good idea in all these ways that the seller does the inspections up front. And let's talk about some cases where a seller might, oh, and also it's a good idea for a seller to do the inspections up front, because in preparation for a seller preparing to put their home on the market, sometimes inspections discover things that a seller could be living in a home for 10, 20, 30, 40 years. That seller doesn't know things about their own home that could be issues. So it's a good way for a seller to be in the know before they list their home about maybe some items that we discussed might be a big issue. It might influence whether a buyer writes an offer on their home. And hey, you know what? We didn't realize there was $12,000 of Section 1 work. We didn't realize there was termite infestations in the back wall or something. Oh my God, that's going to be a huge issue where there's a big plumbing leak under the house, right? So the seller would more than likely definitely want to get those items fixed before we put the home on the market and get into escrow and have a buyer do their own inspections, freak out about the leak, buyer and seller get emotional, buyer says, you know what, screw it, we don't want the house. Now we got an escrow fallout, we got to put the home back on the market, everybody is upset, versus if we had those inspections done, the buyer would have known about everything, the seller had a chance to do some appropriate repairs, and we get a smooth escrow and a good closing and everybody's happy. Now let's talk a minute about why a seller might not want to do pre-inspections, and there's not much of a much good reasoning why a seller doesn't want to do them, but it could be cost. You know, sometimes sellers are, you know, for lack of better terms, they're cheap. They don't want to spend the 800,000 or 1200 bucks on the home, right? They're like, you know what? We don't have them. Maybe they don't have the money, or maybe they just don't want to spend it. They're just like, you know what? Or maybe they're so confident that their home is in a great condition that they don't believe anything's going to come up on the inspections. And you know what? For newer homes or condos or townhomes where the roof and the exterior and the grounds are kept up really well, it's a newer condo, and more than likely, what do you got inside? Some plumbing and some walls and some electrical. More than likely, we know that that stuff's going to be in good shape. You know, that might be justifiable for reasonings for a seller not to want to do the inspections. You also might have a seller not want to do inspections because maybe they're not that serious about selling their home. Maybe they're putting it on the market, they have an agreement with the agent, they're kind of doing a tester, and they don't want to have a lot of skin in the game, right? They don't want to be out the money because they don't really want to sell the home. So that could be another reason right there. But that's not really the case. I'd say 99% of the time, if a seller goes to the trouble of work and changes around their lifestyle, hires a realtor and kind of makes some life plans, and more than likely they're putting their home on the market to sell it, not to goof around. Hence why it's a great idea for a seller to always do inspections. What do inspections cost? Typically here in California, in the Bay Area where I specialize in, you know, for a property, termite, and roof, those are the three main inspections. You can also, there's a couple more inspections sometimes people get. They'll get a chimney inspection, maybe a sewer lateral inspection. There's a company called Pipe Cam that sends a camera down the sewer lateral to check that. But typically people just get, sellers get three inspections, the property, termite, and roof. That covers 98% of everything. And so, yeah, a typical 1,500 to 2,500 square foot home, property, termite, and roof could run you anywhere from 800 bucks to maybe 1,500 bucks, 1,500 bucks, probably 1,500 bucks, something like that. And chimney inspection could run you a couple hundred. Sewer lateral, I think, is about 250, 275. That runs the camera down the sewer lateral. But pretty much property, termite, roof is what 98% of sellers that are getting pre-inspections to list their home get. So great idea, sellers, get those inspections. Be in the know yourself about your property and be in the best position to disclose everything you know about the home to a buyer, so a buyer could come in hot with a possible non-contingent offer, assuring you a smoother escrow, and everybody gets to close the escrow happy, and your home gets sold quickly, efficiently, and effectively, with as less stress as possible. I hope everybody got something out of this video. Have a great day. Take care. Happy house selling.